Hi there.
In this video, we'll be talking about borders and shading in InDesign, so let's get started. We're going to start with inserting a border, and for that, you can just place your cursor anywhere in the paragraph you'd like to add a border to. Now go to the top right corner of the toolbar above and click the burger menu and select paragraph borders and shading option. You'll find two tabs on top, so since we're interested in inserting a border, ensure that you are on that tab. Also check the preview box and then the border box to activate the settings. From the type dropdown, you can select the style of the border you'd like added to your paragraph. I'm going to let it remain to the default setting. Let's update the color of our choice. Let's also increase the offset, because at this point it's too close to our text. You can even select the corner size and shape to style the border. So let's first unlink it, because I don't want to style all four sides. Now focus on the top right corner of the border. First, I'm going to choose a style. So let's pick inverse rounded from here. Since the border has come very close to my text, let's increase the offset a notch and then hit OK. So that's how you can play with the settings and add borders and style them as per your requirement. Another thing you can do with this is add it to a paragraph style. So let's select the text within the border and go to Window and then Styles and select Paragraph Styles. Click the small plus button at the bottom of the Paragraph Styles panel to create a new style and then double click and rename it First Paragraph. Also from the Based On dropdown, select No Paragraph Style as we are not basing it on any preset style and hit OK. Now the best part about this is I can apply the same border without even going to the borders and shading option. All I need to do is place the cursor anywhere in the paragraph I'd like this border added and then click the paragraph style we created and voila! The border is added with the same settings. Alright, let's move to another page and we're going to try shading this time. So place the cursor anywhere in the paragraph and head to the same burger menu on the top right corner of the toolbar above and select paragraph borders and shading option. This time, let's move to the shading tab. Now pick a shading color of choice. If the color is too dark, you can lower the opacity from the tint option. So let's lower it to 50%. Much like earlier, increase the offset a bit so that the shading is not too close to the edge of the text. Let's unlink the corner size and shape as we have room only at the bottom right corner of the shading. Actually, let's move the menu to the left. You see that space? That's where we'll add a shading style. So let's pick one from the dropdown here. Perfect. Now to drag the corner inward, let's increase the size of the corner and it shall move inward. And that's how a paragraph looks after styling the corner. So let's hit OK. Now let's move to another page. This time we'll try a different sort of creativity with shading. So let's place our cursor in the first paragraph here and go to the paragraph borders and shading option. Let's switch to shading tab. Let's pick a different color this time and also lower the opacity to 50%. Also increase the overall offset just a tiny bit. Now what we are planning to do is push the shading towards the left in such a way that it doesn't cover the text at all. So let's unlink the offset settings. Now instead of increasing the offset, let's decrease the offset of the right side of the shading so as to have it touch the extreme left. Now let's increase the left offset a notch to make the rectangle wider. Now that the rectangle is wide enough, let's push it a little further to the left so that it doesn't touch the text. I think this much is good enough, so hit OK. Now the best part about this is when you add text to the first paragraph and it jumps to the next line, the rectangle will also jump with it to maintain the design. So let me copy the second paragraph and then paste it at the end of the first paragraph. And there you go, the text jumps and so does the stylized rectangle. Now let's try one last creativity with our shading here. Let's move to another page and place the cursor anywhere in the first paragraph and then go to paragraph borders and shading option. Let's switch to the shading tab and select a color of choice. Let's reduce the opacity to 70% and then increase the overall offset just a tiny bit. Now unlink the offset option and increase the left offset all the way to the edge of the page and then hit OK. Alternatively, you can increase the right offset as well to touch the spine should you want to. I'm going to let it as it is. To view it in the preview mode, hit W, and that's how the shading style is going to look once printed. Alright guys, that brings us to the close of this session and I shall see you in the next one momentarily. Goodbye.